Krishna, the all attractive. Namaste.
Namaste, friends. Another day. This is our 50th day today. It's a celebration. Every day is a celebration. This is a miracle and a celebration.
Yes, and a surprise. We didn't know we were going to be here 50 days later.
Yeah.
And it would feel like the same now as 50 days ago.
It just feels great. Feels really, really nice. Really nice. My guitar has to go back to the repair. So we may be without this guy again for 1 or 2 days.
Yeah, and also as we're talking about updates, just wanted to say something about the cat, because we have never mentioned our beautiful little cat anymore after you guys were so beautiful and generous with your suggestions for names. And she's still around, she's still there, you can see her. She's not really like the kind of pick up kind of and show kind of cat. Like I don't think I could just bring her here now. I don't think she would love
she's
her.
A hunter. She's a hunter. She's really feed herself. She's always eating creatures and things. It's really not my thing.
We didn't really think about that. We never had a pet, you know.
We were always in hotel rooms. We didn't know that you have to actually clear up their mess, you know.
So this little grassy patch behind us, we call her supermarket, because she sits there most of the day and just
hangs out like in the supermarket
checking out what she could catch. And we with our cat biscuits, we are her McDonald's, I guess.
We're the fast food with the cat biscuits, McDonald's. But she's got all the organic food from the grass there.
So anyway, the story is that the reason why we haven't decided on a name yet, for us she's still the cat.
Kitty, I call her Kitty.
And it's because we are friends with Anna Breitenbach, the beautiful, wonderful animal communicator that I'm sure many of you know from that incredible video on YouTube that went viral about her healing the black leopard.
What's his name? Diablo.
Oh,
if you guys go to YouTube and look that up, put up Diablo, and
or Spirit,
and Diablo Spirit. Yeah. That's it's an amazing clip, and you'll meet Anna there too. Anna is a phenomenon. She's an amazing woman. So yeah, what were you going to say about her? Oh yeah, she is gonna talk to the cat, but
she's gonna talk to the cat, and she's gonna ask her what her name is. So when she came on board with that, I felt like this was too good a chance to miss. I'm just so curious what this cat will say that she likes to be called, but Anna hasn't been able to get to it. So every day we don't know what the name is yet, but I'm sure some of you were wondering, whatever happened to that cat? And I saw a question mark somewhere yesterday. So she's the cat, still. Maybe that's what she wants to be called.
Is that over to you?
Let's do Ahampema, and then let's do
on the wind.
Oh no.
No, it wasn't so good.
Oh no, but it was so good.
Was it nice?
Yeah.
Okay. Was it a bit, it was funny, lost the groove of it. Let's do it later. We'll do it later.
Anyway, it's your song and you sing it, so you can do you can stop
yeah.
it too.
Yeah, it's fine. I can do what I want with. Oh, let's go to the cinema. It's a protection.
Yes.
No? It might be nice, no?
Yes, and we want to dedicate this mantra to
Narasimha.
Narasimha to Petra and her children. She's going through a very hard period, but it's kind of lifting. It's lifting up now. And so just for her family to be in the light. And also to Sheila,
just before you say it, David.
Just let me just finish it.
I know, but you're coming the German way at it. I want to say first what the mantra is, and then we can dedicate it. But first,
okay.
I want you guys to know what it is.
Sorry.
You know what I mean? There's a certain way in the German language that it's difficult. They say something before you know what they're talking about. That's the kind of structure, I think, quite often of the language. So just to sort of make it clear. Narasimha Tavadasoham is a mantra for protection, and it's a good mantra to know. It's a good mantra in these times. It's a great mantra to have with you. It's a beautiful, strong mantra, but it's not a mantra that protects us in an aggressive way. It's not a mantra that protects us like by pushing anything away. This is not that. This mantra opens us to a space of oneness where there is no conflict.
Yeah, it actually guides us to find the right path.
Yeah.
You know, that's what Narasimha is, an ally, a very strong, powerful ally that strengthens us in our choices
right.
that we feel to take, listening to our inner voice.
Right.
And in that way, we are protected to find that path, and also to have the strength to follow that path, even when it's not respected or when it's not immediately supported by the outside world. So that's the protection of Narasimha.
So that's, we want to dedicate it to some people. Now I would like to dedicate to our friends.
And will say afterwards what the words are.
Yeah, and then we say the words and we
okay,
sing.
Yeah. We do it the English way. So again, Petra and her children.
For protection, Petra.
For protection and for being in the light for her family.
Yeah, your little ones.
And Sheila, who is suffering from coronavirus in London, and her mum. Let me get this right. No, Bethany is struggling with coronavirus, and her mum Sheila is in France and can't be with her. And so it's really just, we want to just dedicate this to all the people who are not able to be with their loved ones, especially when one of them is ill and actually would need support, close support. And just that feeling of compassion to you guys and protection, that other people or other energies will protect the person who's going through the illness where they are. So that's Narasimha Tavadasoham. Narasimha Tavadasoham.
Narasimha
Tavadasoham.
we set a plate at home for them off for the meditation. We do that later, maybe. It's a meditation in itself, isn't it? So we can't really do two. Anyway. Okay, beloveds, meditation. Come to our power spot. Actually, before we start our meditation today, shall we all stand up for a moment? If you can stand up, please just stand up for a moment. We're just going to move our bodies a little, just shake our bodies a little before we move into the meditation. And this is such a nice, easy thing to do, and I always recommend it. So it's very simple. We're standing up. We have a feeling of our knees being relaxed and not locked. Don't lock your knees. Relax your knees and just let your body do a little shake. Shake your arms, shake your wrists out, shake your fingers and your hands and your arms. And just relax a little, just shake it out. You can also feel like moving your neck and your head. Don't hold your head and your neck. Give yourself space to start to feel your body as a fluid, energetic vessel. So just relax in your shoulders. If you can see Deva, you can enjoy that too. Relax in your shoulders, relax in your neck. And shaking out any frustration that you have. You shake it out with your arms and your hands. You're feeling in any way a little disconnected. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out so that we can be together. So you just clear the pathway so that nothing prevents you from being in this blessed moment. Shaking, you can feel the whole planet beginning to shake. Whoa, amazing. And now, if you have your mouth closed, open your mouth and relax your jaw. Make a ah sound. Shake it out. This is we hold a lot of, most of our tension in our face is held here in the jaw. So relax your jaw. And this is also good for singing and chanting. Open your mouth, relax, and relax your throat. And keep shaking. You feel it? Your whole body is beginning to move now. And shake your wrists again, your hands. Keep that moving. Keep that moving. But keep your feet like a tree in the earth. Just keep yourself grounded by your feet. You feel your feet on the ground. And your whole body is just shaking off any frustration, any discomfort, any sense of panic. Shake it out. Then we can be together. Shake it out. Use your mouth, use your sound. Yeah, that's good. And your shoulders. Shake your shoulders. Yeah. Okay, now you come down to your pelvic area and relax your whole pelvic area there. Just relax it, let it be nice and loose and relaxed. And our whole body now is a sense of fluid energy. This is who we really are. This is who we really are without our personalities. We are just energy. Blessed energy, not just energy. We're pure energy. Shake a little more, shake it off, feel the fluidity, bring the smile to your face with the that's it. Okay, now we're going to let the shaking descend as if it descends back from the top of your body, from your head down through your neck, your shoulders. Allow it to just slowly descend back into the earth. Through your legs, through your feet, back into the earth. And when you feel all of the shaking come to a stop, you feel just the energy remains. This is who we are, this sense of energy. And take a deep breath in there, nice deep breath, yeah. And another one, nice deep breath. Good, and one more, make the sound ah. Ah. And come to a still point. No movement. Maybe a smile to your being and enjoying this sense of who I really am. What a gift. And we make the Namaste Mudra, thanking ourselves and our great spirit for giving us the gift of life. Namaste. And then we come back to our power spot, sit down, and we will prepare for the chanting mantra Om with Deva. Thank you for sending your photos of your temples. We're very much enjoying the photos that you send now and again, and photos of your temple. And sometimes your pets are there, and we see your children too. It's great and beautiful to be together. This is a gathering of love, compassion, gratitude, and forgiveness. Remember that always. We are here to celebrate. We chant the mantra Om with Deva, and then we move into the Gayatri mantra, and then back to the mantra Om. Our meditation for today. And if you've been with us for 50 days,
you are amazing.
You are amazing. We are blessed. This has deepened. And meditation is deepened and is coming to fruition. It's beginning to permeate our beings now. So if you can come to a point where your body is still, no movement, your spine is straight, your shoulders are relaxed, your hands are relaxed, there's a smile, an inner smile, or maybe even an outer smile, why not? And a relaxed jaw. And we'll go into our meditation.
Om.
Chodaya, Om Bhuvah Svah Tat Sat.
close your eyes, come home. This is the peak of our gathering. You no need to bother with writing a message right now. No need to send a message. Just do a post. Just give yourself a moment. Feel the energy of the mantra. Look up into your third eye with your eyes closed. See the light of the Gayatri. And look for that inner smile. Gratitude, forgiveness, compassion. Straighten your spine. Relax your shoulders. It's so silent today. It reminds me of a song that I made in the ashram long time ago. The song is called Silent Garden. And that's what was the essence of the ashram. It felt like, even though many of us were there, there was a sense of inner peace and silence in the master's garden. All the tears that I have shed over and over and over, healed my heart and cleared my head. Over and over and over, it's my pleasure to be here at your feet. It's my honor and my joy. It's no wonder that I finally meet myself in your sight. It's my pleasure to be here at your feet. It's my pleasure to be here at your feet. It's my honor and my joy. It's no wonder that I finally meet myself in your silent garden.
all beings be happy, may all my thoughts, words and actions contribute in some way to the happiness of all beings.
Luka, samasta, sukino, bhavantu. Luka, samasta, sukino, bhavantu. Luka, samasta, sukino. Samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino.
Namaste.
Namaste.